Welcome back, fellow scientists. Justin here. And guess what? I finally got to go swimming in my favorite pond the other day. So I show up with my favorite pool floaty. I'm sitting in it on the water, relaxing. All's good. And then, plunk, my phone falls out of my pocket and sinks straight to the bottom. Between all my frantic dives trying to get it back, I thought of another question for you. Why does my phone sink, but my floaty floats? Well, to answer this, we're actually going to need to examine how we measure matter. By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to explain how to measure mass and volume, and you'll be able to describe the density of matter. Let's get into it. We already know about one of the ways to measure matter, mass. Remember, mass is a measure of how much matter is in an object. There are several tools we can use to measure mass. One that we've already seen is a balance. A balance can be used to measure the mass of objects through comparison. For example, if both sides of a balance are equal, then we know that the objects on either side have an equal mass. However, if these sides of a balance are unbalanced, as in one is lower than the other, then we know that the object on the side that's lower must have more mass than the object on the other side. We've already seen examples of this. For example, you could probably tell that this hamster has more mass than this pack of gum. But that doesn't really tell us the mass of the hamster now, does it? To find the exact mass of the hamster, we need to compare it to something with a known mass, an object with mass that we've already figured out. For example, these weights all have their masses written right on them in grams. G stands for gram, and a gram is a unit of measurement for mass. It's just like how inches or centimeters are units of length, and how degrees are units of temperature. Okay, so to figure out the mass of the hamster, we're going to gradually add these weights to the other side of the balance until both sides are equal. It seems like we've added 4 10-gram weights and 1 5-gram weight. 10, 20, 30, 40, 45, and now we know that the mass of the hamster is 45 grams. So, it's not really working right now, but I was able to get my phone off the bottom of the pond. What's my phone's mass? Pause the video here and jot down your answer in your guided notes. Okay. So my phone is 140 grams, but its mass doesn't really tell me why it sank when I dropped it in the water. Let's take a look at a different way to measure matter that might answer our question better. Volume. We already know that volume is the amount of space an object takes up. How we measure volume depends on the state the matter is in. Do you remember which states of matter have a definite volume? Yep, solids and liquids. We can measure their volume because all solids and all liquids have a definite volume, unlike gases and plasma. We also know that liquids take the shape of whatever container they're in. So to measure a liquid, all we have to do is pour it into a special container known as a graduated cylinder. A graduated cylinder is a special container that has lines to measure the amount of liquid within it. Each line represents 1 milliliter. That's a unit of volume, just like how a gram is for mass. To find the volume of a liquid, we just pour it into the graduated cylinder and see what line it reaches. For example, this liquid right here goes all the way up to the 80 line. So we know that the volume of this liquid is 80 milliliters. What about the volume of this liquid? Well, it seems to reach somewhere between the 40 and the 50 milliliter line. Let's take a closer look. So graduated cylinders actually work a lot like rulers, in that these kind of longer lines in the middle are the halfway points. So in this case, that line represents the 45 milliliter mark, so we can start counting from there. Each little line is 1 milliliter, so that's 45, 46, 47, 48. The volume of this liquid is 48 milliliters. See if you can determine the volume of this liquid by pausing the video here. Jot your answer down in your guided notes. So, we can find the volume of a liquid by pouring it into a graduated cylinder. But how do we measure the volume of a solid? Remember, solids have a definite shape to them, so we can't just pour it into a container and have it turn into that shape like we can with a liquid. Instead, one of the ways to find the volume of a solid is to place it in liquid and see how much liquid it pushes out of its way. It's just like you making a big splash when you jump into a pool. This is called displacement. Let's see how this works in practice. If I drop this rock into the water in this graduated cylinder, then the rock is going to push some of the water out of its way. The volume of the water it pushes, or displaces, is equal to the volume of the rock itself. The water starts at the 50 milliliter line, and when the rock is added, the water reaches 64 milliliters. By finding the difference between 64 and 50, we can determine that the volume of the rock is 14 milliliters. Try this one on your own. What's the volume of this whistle? Pause the video here and jot your answer down in your guided notes. I think my phone has been dropped into water enough times already, so I'm gonna pass on trying to measure its volume for now. However, there is still one more way of measuring matter that we just haven't talked about yet. Density. Density is how we describe how compact an object is. It's a measure of how much matter is in a given amount of space. Let's take a look at an example. See, this bowling ball and this basketball have the same volume. The two objects take up the same amount of space. However, I'm sure you can agree that the bowling ball has a lot more mass. There's a lot more matter packed into that same amount of space. Therefore, the bowling ball is more compact and it is denser than the basketball. Which do you think has a higher density? A ping pong ball or a golf ball? The golf ball has a higher density. The two are about the same size, but the golf ball has more mass, so it is denser. Density is the measure of how much mass is in a certain area. So to find an object's density, we can take its mass and divide it by its volume. For more information on how to calculate an object's density, be sure to check out the printed activities for this lesson. I think we're getting closer to answering the mystery of why my phone sank here. And I think it's all gonna come down to the density of water. The density of fresh water is 1 gram per milliliter, meaning that every milliliter of water has a mass of 1 gram. Well, that's awful convenient. If an object has a lower density than water, it will float. However, if an object is denser than water, it will sink. For example, an apple is less dense than water, so it floats. A tin can, on the other hand, is denser than water, so it sinks. So that's it! My phone sank when I dropped it because it was denser than the water around it. We finally got to the bottom of it, just like my phone did. Let's review everything that we've learned while solving the mystery of the sinking phone. We can use a balance to measure mass and a graduated cylinder to measure volume. Density is a measure of how compact matter is. It also tells us a lot about if something will sink or float in water. To find out more about measuring matter, check out the activities and practice questions for this lesson. I don't know about you, but the next time I go swimming, I am definitely going to think about density before I bring my phone. That's it for me today. Thank you so much for joining us. And until next time, remember, science is all around us. See you next time. Hey, hey.